first week of Advent in the church's new liturgical calendar. Liturgical colour is purple. The theme of the week is hope. As always, when we gather together in prayer, remembering that we meet in the presence of God, let us all begin by making and saying the sign of the cross.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the 4 weeks leading up to Christmas, we await in hope the arrival of Jesus. Throughout the season of Advent, the Church uses many symbols to help us understand the significance of God becoming one of us. Through the birth of Jesus, one of the most recognised symbols in the Advent wreath is an ancient symbol of the Christian's journey towards Christmas. Every element of the wreath communicates something special about this journey. Its circular shape represents God's eternal love presence. It has no beginning and no end. The evergreen leaves, which never fade in colour, also signifies God's consistency. The candles represent hope, peace, joy, love, and the light of Christ, which shatters all darkness. You can see the three of the candles on the wreath of purple. In the Catholic Church, the colour purple symbolises the new beginnings and times of change. Indeed, the birth of Jesus was to bring about enormous changes across the world, over time and in our lives. They continue to bring about change for the better when we choose to be missionaries of God, love, delivering hope to the world.
On the first week of Advent, we light one purple candle representing hope.
In Advent, the Church has carefully selected readings from the Bible that help Christians around the world journey together towards Christmas. Today's reading, we look at the prophet Isaiah, who lived around 700 years before Jesus. At the time Isaiah's words were written down, his people, the Israelites, were being attacked and oppressed by neighbouring countries. In the midst of such suffering, the Israelites were losing hope. They were turning away from God as their pleas for his help appeared not to be answered, but Isaiah remained faithful.
He believed God was listening and would appear amongst the people, promoting peace, justice and dignity for all. Isaiah tried hard to encourage the Israelites through his actions and words, like those found in the following readings, set for the first Sunday of Advent.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. No ear has heard, no eye has seen any God, but you act like this for those who trust him. You guide those who act with integrity and keep your ways in mind. Lord, you are our Father. We the clay, you're the potter. We are all the work of your hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Isaiah recognised that despite everything, God was still with the people. God has created each and every one of us, and he will never forget us. It is the hope Isaiah has in God that we are reminded of during Advent. The Christian faith teaches that having hope in God does not mean sitting back and doing nothing. Like Isaiah, we should be active in our efforts to make things better. Even if our efforts only seem small, like lighting a candle in a dark room, we must trust that with God's grace, we can shatter darkness and bring hope to others. Sadly, there are many people in the world who live without hope. Living without hope can lead to anxiety and suffering. In hopeless times, we cannot see a way forward, and the future seems lost. There will be people around you who feel this way, here at school, in your communities, perhaps even at home. It is important that as children of God, we follow the example of Jesus, who brought hope to the hopeless by showing them support and care. How might you do that?
Visiting an elderly person, befriending a pupil who is lonely, praying for someone who is struggling to cope. In a speech Pope Francis gave to young people, he reminded us never to doubt our ability to make a difference and be bearers of hope. Wherever it is needed, Pope Francis said, to all young people, I repeat, do not let yourself be robbed. Let us become bearers of hope.
Sometimes it feels as if we're in a rush to speed through the calendar and get to Christmas Day, but Advent challenges that hectic pace of our lives. Advent gives us time to prayerfully remember Jesus' birth and the majesty of the Incarnation while looking ahead to his second coming. Advent is a season of prayer and preparation. Advent prayers can help us to focus on this important liturgical season. When it seems like So many forces pull us from summer to Christmas Eve. Praying during Advent can help us to keep in mind the true purpose of all of the build-up to Christmas, and it can give hope to the millions of people who are feeling far from joyed or loved.
As we begin this new church season, ask yourself, what do I hope for? What else can you hope for? Hope is a great word and theme. It reminds us that we must look for the light in the darkness and always put our trust in what is coming by staying alert and awake.
How will you stay awake and be people of hope this week? Daily life is so very busy. We fill it up with so many things, both necessary and unnecessary. And it's easy to lose track of time or become distracted by things around us that we don't have any room for stillness.
Yet it is in the stillness and the quiet that we can hear God's voice speaking to us and guiding us. It is in those moments of calm and peace that we can connect with ourselves and God. There we can find the opportunity to listen to his words and reflect on the ways that we can truly bring hope to ourselves and to others.
Spend a few minutes in the quiet of your own form room, reflecting on the room you make for God and how you can make a greater space during Advent to do this for yourself and as a way to make time and space to pray for others. Listen to this music and think, what are the lyrics asking of me? How can I make a room for God to write his story this Advent?
You can come as you are.
People of Hope prayer. In the season of Advent, inspire us to be people of hope.
Encourage us not to be greedy for material possession, but for justice and truth.
Inflame us with love for others, which crosses boundaries of race, religion, and nationality.
Stir within us a desire to fight for the integrity of creation and appreciate the immense beauty of the earth.
Be with us, Lord, at this time, that we may be a people of hope. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.